Hey guys, it's Alex here from Homey. In this video, I want to talk to you about Nanoleaf and Homey, of course. Now, Nanoleaf is a relatively interesting company that has brought out some really cool and unique LED panels for in your home. Now, they started with a series called Aurora, which were triangles. Then they added a series called Canvas, which were squares. And now they've added a series called Shapes. And Shapes come in all kinds of different sizes and forms. So at the moment I have hexagons. They've also added triangles and small triangles to the mix. What they're gonna add in future, I'm not sure. But as long as you know you have shapes, they'll always work with Homey. So you can add new lighting panels as you go, and these will always hook up and link up to the flows you're activating with Homey. So I'm gonna show you how we can connect the shapes to Homey and have a look at what we can do with these shapes once we're connected. So how do we have them work in unison with the rest of our smart home? So let's connect up shapes to Homey. In the Homey app, let's head to devices and hit the plus in the top right. Now, since the Nanoleaf shapes are running on our Wi-Fi network, I've already connected them up in the Nanoleaf app and everything's working. They're on my Wi-Fi network. They'll be findable in Discovery. So I can see here that Homey suggests Nanoleaf. So I can just hit that and then select shapes. Just wait one moment while the app is installed on Homey. Once this is done, we can just hit next. Then the pairing instructions is hold the on button for 6 seconds. Let's do this now. And once you've held it down for 6 seconds, you'll see immediately that Shapes has been added to my home. Once the device is connected, you'll see it appear on your home. Now, I'm gonna change the color of these and I wanna make sure that you can see this. So I'm gonna turn off some lights here in the studio. I tap on these two and my lights will turn off. And now you can see the color a little bit better. So you can see that they're a nice light blue color. So let's see what's possible with shapes. Let's hold the tile, and here you can change the dim level. So I can set them a little bit brighter, but you're not gonna be able to see the color that well. So let me turn them down again. And you can turn them off. Really simple, turn them back on. And you can change the color to any color you like. So maybe an orange, looks also really nice. Or let's go to a nice green. And I'll leave it there. Now the Nanoleaf shapes also measures your energy. So if I swipe to the right, I can see my current energy usage. And this is also tracked in the energy overview. Now let's swipe one more to the right and I can create a flow. This is where things get a little bit more interesting and you can start having these become a real part of your smart home. So I want to create a quick flow for these Nanoleaf shapes. Now for my flow, I'm going to keep it really simple. I'm going to say when this flow is started, then I want a scene to activate on my panels. So if I head down to devices and shapes, I get a range of actions that I can have happen. So this ranges from changing the color, setting the hue, temperature, those kind of things, to also including set an effect. And the effects are kind of the fun and unique thing about Nanoleaf. So I'm gonna set an effect and then select an item. And here are all the effects that I also have on my Nanoleaf app that have been imported into Homey. So I can add these to a flow. Now, one of my favorites is Northern Lights. So I'm gonna select this one as part of my flow. I don't want a delay, but remember you can add this if you want to. And I'll hit the check in the top right. I'll quickly save it as Northern Lights and hit save. Now that this is set up, I can also just test it. So I'll hit the test. And you'll see the panels change to the Northern Lights scene. Now I've had these Nanoleaf shapes set up in my home for a couple weeks now. And one of the flows that I found really useful is to have them turn off with the rest of my zone. So if I'm turning off the lights in my office, for instance, I also want these to turn off. And that way I don't have to open another app and have it turn off in that way. It's a little bit too much work. So I just want them to turn off with a flow. So let's create that. If I head back to my device, and hold down on it and head to settings, I can change the zone it's in. So I'm gonna put it in my office zone and hit the check mark. Now that they're in my office, I can create a flow to turn off the lights in that zone. Let's do this. I'm gonna head into shapes, head to the flow section and hit plus. For the when card, I'm gonna say when this flow is activated so that I can quickly activate the flow when I wanna turn off my lights. For the then card, I can then say, under devices, I can turn specific devices off. If I tap on that, it gives me the option to select the device type, in this case, a light. and it asks what zone they're in. So I can say my office. Now that I have that set up, I can hit the check mark, hit save, give it a quick name, turn off lights in the office, hit save, and this is now an active flow. So if I head back to my flow overview, I should be able to activate this and have the lights turn off in my office. Let's try that. I'm gonna head back and head over to flows. Here I can see turn off lights in the office, hit play, and the panels turn off, along with the rest of the lights in my office. I can show you this by going back to devices, and here in my office zone, all the lights have turned off. If I turn them back on and tap on shapes, this also comes back on. So this is a really effective way to make sure that the panels turn off with the rest of your zone. Or if you're leaving home, you can create a flow to turn off all the lights at home, and that also includes these panels. That way, you're not consuming unnecessary electricity. Right now, you can see the lights are still on that northern light setting. Now, I want to show you a little bit how these tiles work. So if I unclip this shape over here, it just pops right out. And I can actually place it anywhere I want to, and it'll stay using this scene. With the panel unclipped, there's a little connection piece that also becomes unclipped. So if I lift up the tile, I can unclip that, and I can move this connector to wherever I want. So on each of these sides, there's a connection piece. So if I want to, I can place it right under here. Gotta find the middle of this, and then click it into place. Then we can move the tile and place that on top. Now you'll see immediately that the tile becomes part of the pattern. So you can see that whatever scene you have, in whatever shape you want to make it, it continues with that lighting scene. And this is really the power of these shapes. So you can design an LED lighting panel on your wall in any way that you want it. There's another fun feature I want to show you, and this has to do with music. So the Nanoleaf can also respond to musical beats to a certain song. And that's quite a cool effect. Now I have a Sonos here in my studio, and if I hit play, then the music will start. Now the next step is to hit the little music icon here on the tile. So you can see that the tiles now react to the beat of the music. Super fun if you're having a party and these are set up in your living room. Now I'm quickly gonna turn this off again, but I just wanted to highlight that fun effect. Now let's head back into flows and activate the northern lights. Now I've tried to show you a little bit what these Nanoleaf shapes have to offer. And I've also tried to illustrate the power of flows in connecting this and making it part of your smart home using Homey. Now have fun with this and create your own flows for having these become a part of your home.